Good morning. A warm welcome to each one of you for today's chapel service. Let's look to the Lord in prayer. Our most merciful, loving, gracious Heavenly Father, we worship you and we adore you, God. We thank you for this lovely day. We are in your presence, O God. We do remember those who are suffering. You heal them, give them life, O Master. Father God, we thank you and praise you for this service. Many will be blessed by listening to your word, O Master. We ask this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. I have a few announcements. Staff, those who are celebrating your birthdays during the course of this week, a very happy birthday to all of you. And please meet our director on Friday, 2:10 p.m. in the boardroom. I have a verse for you, Psalm 34:7. The angel of the Lord encamp around those who fear him and deliver them. The Lord is with you and bless you as you continue to remain in his presence. And those who are newly joined employees, a warm welcome to each one of you, and may God bless you as you continue to work with us. Let's worship the Lord as Dr. Sophia will lead us into praise and worship.
Welcome everybody for the Friday service. Let's all worship the Lord.
My God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hand hath made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think of God, his Son not sparing, send him to die, I scarce can take it in, that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, that I shall bow with humble adoration, and then
We are very glad to have Dr. Sean, and he's going to deliver the message. Over to Dr. Sean.
Greetings, Baptist family. I earnestly pray that this message finds you in good spirits. But even if it may not, being aware of the times we are in, I hope that through the message I have for you, you will find hope. We're living in strange and uncertain times, and the one emotion that has gripped us all without bias is the fear of losing control. And that is what we call anxiety. You're anxious because you know that you do not have control over the safety of your family, over your children's education, over your job, your investments, and for a matter of fact, you even realize now that we don't have control over our own lives. But the Bible offers many sure cures for our anxiety, and I will highlight just three of them today. Number one is cultivate reasonable expectations, and number two will be rest your head on the pillow of God's sovereignty. And number three is the gospel. Let's look at number one. What do I mean by cultivating reasonable expectations? In the gospel according to John chapter 16, Jesus is having a discussion with his disciples and talking about how they will go through various trials and difficulties. He even tells them that their very life may be under threat. And then in verse 33, he says, "I have said these things to you that in me you may have peace." What? How is it that knowing you will go through difficult times, how will that give you peace? Well, it does. In a way, it will set right expectations for you. If you are prepared for difficult times, you will not be surprised when life is hard. If you are rooted in Christ and have a living relationship with Him and rightly expect trials in life, He assures you that you will have peace. And so any teaching that tells you that being a follower of Christ means health, wealth, and prosperity, that is contrary to what Christ says in verse 33 when He says, "In this world you will have tribulations." So prepare your minds and develop a pattern of thinking in which you expect difficult times, and then you will not be very disappointed with life. The next one I have is you should rest your head on the pillow of Christ's sovereignty. What do I mean by Christ being sovereign? I mean that Christ is absolutely 100% in control over everything in this world. Unlike me and you, He is in total control of all creation, which is why in Matthew 10 verse 29, Christ says, "Even a sparrow does not fall to the ground without the Father's knowledge." If God is sovereign over such insignificant events, how much more must He care about you? And it is because that He is sovereign over all things, He is able to guarantee us in Romans 8:28 that all things, whether sickness, poverty, broken marriage, or even a pandemic, all things can work together for good. Note, He doesn't say that you will only have good in your life. He says all things, whether it is good or bad, will work towards the good for you if you love God. Friends, He is ultimately and intimately holding your life and my life and everything around us, even as we speak now. Corona too is in Christ's hands, and it cannot cross the boundaries that He has drawn. And so you can rest your burdened hearts and your heavy heads on this comforting truth that God is in absolute control over your life. And finally, I come to the last cure for anxiety, and that is the gospel. If I may be honest with you, none of what I said above may make sense to you or be of any benefit to you if you haven't embraced the gospel. Now, what is the gospel? The gospel story begins thousands of years back when God created the first man and the first woman that represented you and me. He created them good, but they rebelled, just like you and me. Following their first act of sin, anybody born into this world is born a sinner because we have inherited the sinful nature of our first parents. Not only that, we also intentionally sin, both in our thought and in our deed. Don't we? Even our good works are stained by sinful intentions, and so we can never work our way to God or earn favor with God because of our works. And so if God, who is holy, were to be just with us, He should have destroyed us all. And that is why the Bible says all have fallen short of the glory of God, and the wages of sin, that is what you deserve, is death. But friends, here is the good news. God, in His mercy and love, realizing that there is no way you can work your way to Him or to heaven, provided a way for us to be reconciled to Him. And this is through the Lord Jesus Christ. And that is why Christ says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And so if you will, or anybody will, repent of their sins, turn to God, and put their faith in Christ and His sacrifice on behalf of their sins, they will receive forgiveness of sins and eternal life. Anyone will. And that is the gospel. That is the good news. You don't have to fear death or judgment of God after death, because if you have put your faith in Christ, death is only a doorway into eternal life with Christ. And so let me summarize. There are three ways in which you can cure your anxious thoughts. Firstly, by rightly expecting trials and tribulations in this life and finding your peace in Christ. Secondly, by resting in the reality that God is in absolute control over every detail of your life, and it is working out for your good. And thirdly, and most importantly, by receiving Christ's offer of forgiveness of sins, life eternal. Even after you die, you will have everlasting joy in the presence of God. God bless you.
ಪ್ರಿಯರೇ, ಇಂದಿನ ಒಂದು ವಾಕ್ಯವನ್ನು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಶಾನ್ ಅವರು ಸುಂದರವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈ ವಾಕ್ಯದ ಒಂದು ಸಾರಾಂಶ ಹೀಗಿರುತ್ತದೆ. ಮೂರು ಅಂಶಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ನೋಡುತ್ತೇವೆ. ಯೋಹಾನನ್ ಬರೆದ ಸುವಾರ್ತೆ 16:33 ವಚನದಿಂದ ನಾವು ನೋಡುವುದಾದರೆ, ಕಠಿಣ ದಿನಗಳು ಬರಲಿವೆ, ಆದರೆ ನೀವು ಶಾಂತವಾಗಿರಿ ಎಂಬುದಾಗಿ ಹೇಳುತ್ತದೆ. ಲೋಕವನ್ನು ನಾನು ಜಯಿಸಿದ್ದೇನೆ, ಆದರೆ ನೀವು ಜಯಿಸುವವರಾಗಿದ್ದೀರಿ ಎಂಬುದಾಗಿ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ. ಹಾಗಿರುವಾಗ ಪ್ರಿಯರೇ, ಭಯವು ಎಲ್ಲರ ಹೃದಯದಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬಿಕೊಂಡಿರುವಾಗ ಈ ಭಯವು ಅನೇಕರನ್ನು ಚಿಂತೆಗೆ ಒಳಪಡಿಸುವಂಥದ್ದಾಗಿದೆ. ಆದರೆ ಕರ್ತನ ವಾಕ್ಯವು ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಅಭಯ ನೀಡುವಂಥದ್ದಾಗಿದೆ, ಧೈರ್ಯ ನೀಡಿ ನಮಗೆ ಶಾಂತಿಯನ್ನು ಕೊಡುವಂಥದ್ದಾಗಿದೆ. ಆದ ಕಾರಣ ಈ ವಾಕ್ಯದ ಆಧಾರದ ಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ಭಯಪಡದೆ ದೇವರಲ್ಲಿ ಶಾಂತಿಯನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿ ನಾವು ಜೀವಿಸೋಣ. ಎರಡನೇ ಅಂಶವು, ನಾವು ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತನಲ್ಲಿ ವಿಶ್ರಮಿಸೋಣ. ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಕ್ರೈಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ವಿಶ್ರಮಿಸೋ. ಕೆಲವೊಮ್ಮೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸು ನಮಗೆ ವಿಶ್ರಾಮ ಮಾಡುವುದಕ್ಕೂ ಕೂಡ ಬಿಡುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಆತನು ಮೂಲ ಕರ್ತನಾಗಿದ್ದಾನೆ. ರೋಮಪುರದವರಿಗೆ ಬರೆದ ಪತ್ರಿಕೆ 8:28 ವಚನದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳುತ್ತದೆ, ಸಮಸ್ತವು ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತದೆ ಯಾರ್ಯಾರು ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತನನ್ನು ಪ್ರೀತಿಸ್ತಾರೆ ಎಂಬುದಾಗಿ ದೇವರ ವಾಕ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಮತ್ತು ಮತ್ತಾಯ 10:29 ವಚನದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ದೇವರು, ನೀವು ಹಕ್ಕಿಗಳನ್ನು ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡಿರಿ, ಅವು ಬಿತ್ತುವುದಿಲ್ಲ, ಕೊಯ್ಯುವುದಿಲ್ಲ, ಆದರೆ ಅವುಗಳನ್ನು ನಾನು ಸಲ್ಲುವಂಥ ದೇವರಾಗಿದ್ದೇನೆ, ಆದ ಕಾರಣ ನೀವು ಚಿಂತೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಡ್ರಿ ಎಂಬುದಾಗಿ ಅಭಯವಚನದ ಯೇಸು ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮೂರನೇ ವಚನದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ನೋಡುವಾಗ ಸುವಾರ್ತೆ ಎಂಬುವ ವಿಷಯವನ್ನು ನಾವು ಧ್ಯಾನಿಸಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಸುವಾರ್ತೆ ಎನ್ನುವಾಗ ಮಾನವನು ಹುಟ್ಟಿದಂದಿಲ್ಲಿಂದನೂ ಪಾಪಿ ಎಂಬುದಾಗಿ ನಾವು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಮನುಷ್ಯನು ಅನೇಕ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಪಾಪದಿಂದ ಬಿಡುಗಡೆ ಹೊಂದಬೇಕು, ನಾನು ನೀತಿವಂತನಾಗಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನುವಂಥ ಆಸೆ ಪ್ರತಿ ಮನುಷ್ಯನಲ್ಲಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಆದರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ಪಾಪಗಳಿಂದ ಪರಿಹಾರ ಪಡೆಯೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಮಾರ್ಗವನ್ನು ಹುಡುಕುತ್ತೇವೆ. ಆದರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾವ ಪರಿಹಾರವಿಲ್ಲ ಎಂಬುದಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಕಾಣುತ್ತೇವೆ. ಆದ ಕಾರಣ ದೇವರು ಲೋಕದ ಮೇಲೆ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಪ್ರೀತಿಯನ್ನು ಇಟ್ಟು ಯೇಸುಕ್ರಿಸ್ತನನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ಪಾಪಗಳ ಪರಿಹಾರಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಕಳಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಯೇಸು ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಬಂದು ತನ್ನ ರಕ್ತವನ್ನು ಸುರಿಸಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಪರಾಧಗಳನ್ನು ಆತನು ಅಳಿಸಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಮಗೆ ರಕ್ಷಣೆಯನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಮರಣದಿಂದ ಜೀವಕ್ಕೆ, ನಿತ್ಯ ಜೀವಕ್ಕೆ ನಡೆಸಿರುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ಶುಭವಾರ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಅದು ಶುಭವನ್ನು ಮತ್ತು ಸಂತೋಷವನ್ನು ಉಂಟು ಮಾಡುತ್ತದೆ. ಇಂಥ ಒಂದು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ವಾಕ್ಯ ದೇವರು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಆತ್ಮೀಯ ಲಾಭಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಆಶೀರ್ವದಿಸಲಿ.
Let's look to God in prayer. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you and praise you once again for giving all of us the gift of life. We also want to thank you for ministering to us. Lord, we pray that help us that we would come and draw closer to you. And Lord, draw hope and strength and courage from you, acknowledging that you are with us in every moment of our life. We commit each one of us into your loving hands, and we ask this in Jesus' most precious name. Amen. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of the Father, and the sweet abiding presence of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. All right, God bless you and have a great day.